Have you ever wanted to rent a high-end PC so you could install and play whatever you wanted, whenever you wanted? The cloud gaming service, Shadow PC, will be right up your alley. Shadow allows you to stream a high-end PC to all the devices it supports. Shadow supports many different devices, including Windows, Android, and Apple devices. So don't worry if your device is supported. Shadow requires a monthly subscription and is decently cheap, so you should be able to afford playing top-of-the-line games every single month without having to worry about updating your PC. Now, if you're able to get access to a Shadow PC right now, then you're one of the lucky ones. Shadow is on pre-order as they're expanding their PC services. So if you don't already have a subscription, getting a Shadow PC is pretty hard to come by right now. So if you have your Shadow PC subscription active and you're looking to get started, this is the video for you. The first thing you're going to want to do is go to their website at shadow.tech and download the app. Once you're at the homepage, click on the Downloads link at the top. The top download will present the correct download for your system. Notice that I'm running a Windows machine that is 64-bit. I'm going to hit this download because this is the one I need. If you need something else, feel free to download it below. Once done downloading, hit the Install and let it run through its process just like any other application on your computer. You'll see the loading of the application launcher open up from here. This is where you'll log into your account and activate your Shadow PC. After you put in your credentials to log in, keep your email handy because Shadow will then send you a verification email with a code to authorize this device you were on to use the Shadow PC. If you have a successful login and authorization, Shadow is going to want to go through a PC diagnostic test so it can determine what settings are best for your setup. My internet connection is pretty decent, but if your internet is not up to snuff, it might give you some suggestions on how to fix it. Hitting continue will finally get you to the home screen of the Shadow app. A changelog will appear with updates and features on the app. From here, you can go right into launching your Shadow PC. But first, let's check out some of the icons in the app launcher. The person icon in the top left corner is your user setting dropdown. This will give you the ability to change your account settings, send feedback to the developers, or simply log out of Shadow. The gear icon next to the home tab is the settings tab. Here you can change the app settings specifically for your PC configuration. Now, I wouldn't mess with these settings until you've actually tried using your Shadow PC first. I also would only recommend messing with these settings if you have a lower-end PC to get the best performance out of your machine while you're using your Shadow PC. Take a quick look at these settings to see if you need to modify any of these settings down the road. The question mark icon is the Help tab. Here you'll be able to find out the status of the Shadow service. You will also be able to see any help pages and contact support for any questions you might have on the service. The Help tab also features quick tips and keyboard shortcuts to help you out while using the Shadow system. Now, let's travel back home and hit Start Now for the main event. The first time you start your Shadow PC, it will start setting up your custom Windows PC with the latest updates and graphics drivers it needs to run your games properly. Be prepared to wait a few minutes. It took me about 5.5 minutes to complete the setup. We'll speed up the process for your convenience. We are now into our Shadow PC. I'm sure you've noticed that things look familiar. Yes, your shadow PC is basically a high-end Windows PC in the cloud. As long as you have a subscription and the service is up, you can log into your shadow PC and use it at any time. One of the most important things to know about how to use your shadow PC is the quick menu. You can access the quick menu by hitting the shadow logo at the top, or by hitting the keyboard keys Window, Alt, and O. The first thing you'll notice about the quick menu is the wonderful feature of the usage stats that are displayed in real time on the right-hand side. Data geeks rejoice! One of the big features of the quick menu is that it becomes the gateway to your shadow PC and the gateway out of your shadow PC. You'll also notice that your options like exiting and going window screen are all at the top of the quick menu dashboard. Take a look as we hit the button exit full screen and hit the button again to go right back in. Another thing the quick menu allows you to do is connect all your peripherals, including your controllers, microphones, and any other USB devices you may have. Close the quick menu and you're off. Have fun. Install what you want and play what you want, as long as you have a decent internet connection. One of the first things I tested was how fast games were downloaded to the system. As you can see, I was getting upwards of almost 80 megabytes per second on a download. Now granted, every game is different, also every system is different. So don't count on every game moving at this speed. Shadow PC is a dream for PC gamers who don't want to drag their hardware everywhere you go to play top-of-the-line games. It's like being able to have a high-end pocket PC wherever you go. If you are the PC gamer type, sign up now so you can get full access as soon as they open more PCs up for usage. In the meantime, if you like this Shadow PC walkthrough, give us a like, and feel free to subscribe so you can get the latest news, gameplay, and comparisons on cloud gaming at the only place where you can do battle in gaming heaven, Cloud Gaming Battle.